Since Hyundai arrived in the US in the early 90s, the company has been adding building blocks to make a well-rounded brand. At first, it was value for money, and then quality, and then design, and now they're focused on performance. And that is where Hyundai's N Performance brand comes in. And this is the first US spec model from that division. It's the Hyundai Veloster N, and it's competing directly with the Golf GTI, the Honda Civic Type-R, the Ford Focus ST. What we're gonna do is take a first drive in it and see whether it can really match up with those premium hot hatchbacks. A performance car is more than just the way it drives, it's also the look. So for the Veloster N, Hyundai added some specific styling cues that help it stand out from the regular Veloster Turbo. Up front, we've got a wide black mesh grille with N badging here, and there are these black accents here on this red model, but on other colors, they're painted red. We also have this air ducting on the side that helps cool those front brakes. On the side, we see this performance pack equipped model has 19-inch wheels wrapped in Pirelli P-Zero tires. The standard car has 18-inch rims wrapped in Michelin Pilot Super Sport tires. Also very good, but not as sticky as these Pirellis. Working our way back, we see the single driver door. If we were on the passenger side, you'd see two doors. Yes, it's a three-door design. That's been the same way since Hyundai introduced the Veloster several years ago. Here we arrive at some of the more distinctive aerodynamic components to the Veloster N. We've got a double level rear spoiler. Down here, a unique rear fascia with an integrated diffuser and two big oval exhaust ports. And that isn't just for look. You're also getting a unique exhaust tune and sound to the vehicle. Okay, so it has the visual aggression. What about the mechanical aggression to go with it? 2.0-liter turbocharged four-cylinder, 250 horsepower in standard guise. If you get the performance pack, you've got 275 horsepower. No extra hardware, just tuning. 260 pound-feet of torque across the line, and a six-speed manual gearbox is your only transmission. Brake-based torque vectoring, also standard. Optional as part of the performance pack is an electronic limited slip differential. Front brakes, 13-inch calipers, 13-inch rotors. Geez, 13-inch calipers, that would be massive. 11.8-inch rear rotors, sliding single piston at both ends. The brakes are not Brembo kits like many of these hot hatchbacks have. They are internal bits that Hyundai says is up to the task of putting stopping power to this Veloster N. After spending some time on track, I would agree with them. I think they're very much up to the task. And cooling has been enhanced as well so that you're not gonna overheat when you take it to the track.
Okay, initial thoughts on this cabin. Sporty accents, we got blue accents here, and then on the dials, blue stitching on the seats, blue seat belts, that's fun. But apart from those details, it's a little plain black and some hard plastics and stuff, but it does have character to the design. The dashboard isn't just monochromatic, it does have some depth and some styling cues that I dig. The gear selector is a nice leather wrapping to it, along with this aluminum trim. Headspace is good, visibility is good, except for the C pillar back there. Not too much trouble though. I'm feeling this cabin, folks.
All right, we got the car in motion now. I can give you some first impressions of it driving on the road before we take it on the track a bit later. The first thing that jumps out at me is how well set up these dampers are. They're ultra smooth. For a car of this performance capability, I'm not getting a lot of that jostling, jarring feeling that you get in the cabin of some of these hot hatchbacks. This is just continuously smoothing out the road. There is a bit of road noise, I will note that. The tire noise and road noise is definitely getting into the cabin here at speeds above 60 miles an hour. But the ride quality is excellent, and that is something that's gonna be very important for a car like this that's gonna spend the vast majority of its time just going around town and on highways. And when you do get on it, there's plenty of pep. That torque comes in real early and hangs around. The shifts are short, crisp, a lot of communication from the gearbox. I like that. The steering, I'm just in normal mode. There's a sport mode. The steering weight is excellent, good feedback, and certainly it goes where you point it. And what I like about this is on some Hyundai vehicles, it's busy on center. There's never really a true center point to the steering. It's moving one way or another and you're constantly fighting it. This, I feel like, has a true on center. And even Jeff Glucker, when he was reviewing the Turbo R spec, said the same. And on this car, it is different, so they've definitely done the right changes to the steering. I could really live with this car on a day-to-day. It rides well, and apart from a bit of road noise, it's comfortable and has that performance when and where you want it.
Welcome to Thunder Hill Raceway in Willows, California. So we know the Veloster N is pretty darn good on the road, but how about on a racing circuit? And one like this that has a whole lot of elevation change, blind corners, off-camber corners. We're throwing a lot at this car today. Now, the first thing I look for when I hop into a performance car is the brake feel. And there, the Veloster N delivers with good initial bite and strong feel all the way up to the point where you're turning in. Next thing is the steering. Here we have a good amount of weight, not overly hefty, very direct, and this is mounted to the rack on the Veloster N as opposed to the column, and what I get there is a bit more communication. That electronic limited slip differential is definitely doing its job. The car isn't understeering all that much. It does a bit at the absolute limit, but there's no slip. Gearbox is excellent. Throws are short, crisp. I know exactly when I've engaged the gear. And power coming out of corners is robust. No delay. It's just getting that power down so nicely. The chassis is tight. Not a ton of flop in the corner, just good rotation. It plays with you a little bit too, which I really appreciate. This is an excellent, excellent first model out of N Performance here in the US. I know they have the i30N in Europe, but they told us straight up. They said this car is just better. It's lower, it's better tuned, the suspension is more dialed. America, we've got a new player, and its name is N Performance.
Miles had to step out for a second, so I'm just gonna jump in and finish
Jeff?
His...
What are you doing here, man?
I just wanted to drive it.
You drove the R-Spec.
It's not the same.
Well, that's at least true. Anyway, that is the Hyundai Veloster N. If you wanna get more pricing information for your area, go ahead and click the button below.